This tutorial shows how to conduct the paired sample t-test in R and interpret its results. The purpose is testing the means for a paired or the same sample at two different points in time for differences. For instance, I let people do a 4-week long training and want to compare the number of push-ups they can do before and after the training. The requirements for the paired sample t-test are the following. Two dependent measurements for these same individuals, a dependent variable on an interval or ratio scale, and an approximate normal distribution of the residuals. Testing for normal distribution is shown in the video linked in the info cards to keep this video as concise as possible. As a first step, after importing your long format data, I want to see the sample mean and standard deviation of the number of pushups for my two points in time. One can use the convenient dplyr-package and pipes. Start with the group by function and put in your data frame and the time variable. Follow this up with the pipes operator and use the summarize function for the mean and standard deviation on your test variable, in my case, V. The means are 22 and 25.2 for the first and second measurement respectively. You can also visualize the two groups and the respective distribution by using boxplots. I recommend the ggpumpr package and its ggboxplot function as shown on screen. Now I want to test whether the means are significantly different from each other or not. For this, I use the t.test function and start off with the test variable, the repetitions. After that, I use tilde, the small wave symbol, and put the time variable behind it. Furthermore, the argument paired equals true is necessary to do a paired t-test. Please note that the default testing will be two-sided, meaning you test only for a difference. In case you proposed in advance that the first measurement of your test variable has a smaller mean than the second one, you can add the argument alternative equals less. If you hypothesized a greater mean for the first measurement though, use alternative equals greater. I will now simply run the two-sided option and interpret the results. Of all the output, you should focus your attention on the p-value. If the p-value is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis assumes no difference of the mean between measurements 1 and 2. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis, because my p-value for a two-sided test is 1.5 times 10 to the negative 10. I can therefore conclude that the means, 22 and 25.2, are different. If I tested one-sided for a larger mean of measurement 2 compared to measurement 1, I could certainly see that result as well. The p-value would then be halved. Eventually, I can conclude that the 4-week training helped to increase the number of push-ups individuals were able to do. After a significant paired t-test, the effect needs to be quantified using effect sizes, which is shown in the following video.